Hi guys, we will do a Marketo office hour dedicated to the Marketo setup. We'll see all the options in the setup, what are the pitfalls to be avoided, and make sure that you have a perfectly operational Marketo so that you do great marketing. Let's go. So we'll do this session on the Marketo setup that we found in the admin part here, and I will see all the options here, not from top to bottom, but let's say by order of importance. So let's start with the Munchkin here, which is how Marketo listens to what happens on the website, who visits which page, and who clicks on any link. So you have this Munchkin code, this JavaScript code that you have to put on your website. And usually we use this one. Almost never see anyone using the simple or asynchronous query. That's for very rare occasions. And so you see that your tracking code contains your Munchkin code ID, which is personal to you. And you have to put that, you know, on your website, whether you put that on the header, on the footer directly, or like me, you use, for instance, Google Tag Manager or any tag manager you like. And here in my Google Tag Manager, I have this tag Marketo Engage. I've put the exact code Marketo gave me here. And I said, please trigger that as soon as the person accepts the functional cookie. This is my choice. Some of you may want to trigger that when the person accepts marketing cookies. I prefer to trigger Marketo all the time. And I've not triggered this cookie on the Marketo landing page because the tracking is automatically done by Marketo. And what else? If I come back on the screen, please be aware that in Europe, we have to support the Do Not Track browser request. By default, it's ignore, and we have to check support in Europe to be compliant with the GDPR. So on your website, once you have put that, if you go to your browser and you go to the console, I'm on my website here, I go to in Firefox, here on this menu.